The board foot is a typical means of measuring wood, and a board foot is 1 inch thick by 1 foot wide by 1 foot long.
While there's only one definition for a board foot, there are many different methods of calculating the amount of board feet in a log. A log rule is a formula for estimating the board foot volume of wood in a log, and it depends upon two variables: the diameter at the smaller end of the log and the length of the log. There are three common log rules used in our region: Doyle, Scribner, and International. The formulas for each of these rules uses different assumptions, so they will provide different estimates of the volume in a log. The three assumptions in these log rules are: one, the log is a cylinder with either no allowance for taper or a fixed rate per foot. Two, the log is cut into boards by a blade with specific width, the kerf. And three, an allowance for slabs, the amount of wood along the edge of a log. Log rules are approximations of the amount of wood in a log. None provide the exact amount that will be cut. The Doyle log rule was proposed in 1825 and is still widely used in the eastern and southern United States for hardwood logs. Doyle is also commonly used in Iowa and Nebraska for hardwood logs, especially for high-value walnut logs. The Doyle rule assumes a saw kerf, the thickness of the cutting blade, of 5/16 inch and subtracts 4 inches for slabs and edging, about twice the amount for other log rules. Doyle is considered one of the most inaccurate log rules. It underestimates small logs, those less than 10 or 12 inches in diameter at the small end, due to its high slab allowance. There is no allowance for the taper of the log. The Scribner log rule was published in 1846, and it's not commonly used in much of the country, but still applies in Minnesota and eastern South Dakota. The Scribner rule assumes 1 inch lumber cut into widths of 4, 6, or 8 inches. It also assumes a saw kerf of 1/4 inch. There is no formula for slab or edging, as Scribner is a diagram rule created from fitting boards into a perfect circle that represents the log end, so it will underestimate volumes in logs longer than 16 feet. It does not have an allowance for taper and assumes a minimum log length of 4 feet. The Scribner rule underestimates smaller logs, though not to the extent of the Doyle. There is also Scribner decimal C, where the board foot volume is rounded to the nearest 10 board feet. For example, 78 board feet in the Scribner is rounded to 80 board feet for Scribner decimal C. The International 1/4 rule was developed in 1906. The rule allows for a 1/4 inch saw kerf and a fixed taper allowance of 1/2 inch per 4 feet of log. Deductions are also allowed for a slab thickness that varies with the log diameter. Overall, the International 1/4 log rule is the most consistent and often is used as a basis for comparing other log rules. While it is considered the most accurate log rule, it is not as widely used as either the Doyle or Scribner in the Midwest region of the United States. Log scaling is applying a log rule to a log and taking any necessary allowances for defects, such as rot, sweep, or knots. Rules for accounting for defects are sometimes difficult to apply, and there can be considerable variation among scalers depending on their experience. As a result, most of our portable mill operators either do not accept logs with many defects or will cut a log to a shorter length to remove the defective portion and scale only the sound portion.
Doyle, Scribner, and International are the three log rules we use to measure board foot volume. But the rules change depending on whether we're talking about the standing tree stumpage or the log.